While working on the various web design projects, I have created many kinds of delightful link hover effects. But every time I wanted to create a hover effect, I had to either use extra markup to my HTML document or sometimes maybe generated content using after and before pseudo element selectors. But in this video, I will be showing you how to go ahead and create these link hover effects without using any kind of extra markup except a single anchor element. So friends, welcome to Smash the Shell. I am Amit Kumar, and in this video tutorial, we are going to create some custom link hover effects by using CSS only without any extra markups. So friends, let's go ahead and get started. As you can see that we have two documents right now, index.html and style.css. I have already linked this style.css to my HTML document, and inside this body element we have a simple link tag, actually anchor tag with a class of link, which has a custom text. And if you look at the CSS file, I am applying some basic styles to center the link in this browser viewport. You can see that here, both vertically and horizontally. And I'm applying a custom font family and some custom font size. That's it. Now, my friends, let's go ahead and start styling this link. So what I can do here is that I can target the link class, and I want to first of all remove that underline because we are not going to use that. So I can say text decoration and set it to none. I want to give it a custom color, so I'm going to use SSHSL and 220 for the hue. Saturation should be 100% and lightness is going to be 20%. Hit save and let's give it a font weight of 700. Now that's it. Now for the next part, what we want to do is that we want to create a gradient background for this link text in such a way that it looks like a strip and it has two parts. The top part should be a transparent one and the bottom part should be a solid color. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Here you can see that I have a custom link text here, and beneath it we have this solid color background, and the first part is the kind of transparent. It's gray for now, which I have represented as a transparent color, and this is the solid color. So we are going to create this kind of background by using the CSS gradients. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's create a background image property and set its linear gradient to, first of all, we need to give a direction. So since we want the gradient from top to bottom, and so I have to use to bottom. And then the second part that we need is a color value. Now that color should be transparent, so I'm saying transparent and 0 to 50%. So it should go up to 50%, and after 50% we need kind of a solid color. So I'm gonna say HSL and I'm gonna use 20 hue and 100% saturation and 80% lightness to get this color. Now hit save and you're gonna see something like that. But as you can see that we need a hard line right in the middle of this custom link. So I can say 50% once again, and now you're gonna see that how sharp that line is. So if you look at the code editor by maximizing it, you're gonna see how this total syntax looks. Now it might be not clear to some of you, so let me explain it a little further how this is working. Here we are saying transparent 0%, but what I haven't done is that I could also specify transparent 0 to transparent 50, then HSL solid color from 50% to HSL 20, 100%, 80%, something like this. So it will still look the same. So in this way, the syntax would have been much longer, as you can see that here. Okay, and if you look at the result, there is no change to it. So there is an alternative syntax to kind of create a gradient like this by using the newest syntax that is announced in CSS3. So let me show you how it works. Just simply go ahead and comment this out, and let's go ahead and create background image once again. And this time we're gonna create linear gradient to bottom. And this time what we are going to do is that we are going to provide two color stop positions at the same time for the single color, individual colors like that. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Transparent 0 to 50% like this, and HSL 20, 100%, 80%, and just specify 50% to 100%. Now my friends, if you look into the browser, you're gonna get the same results, but the problem is that it is kind of not supported in all the previous browsers, maybe right around browsers that were built in kind of 2017 and before. So if you are using the updated browsers, there will be no problems with this syntax. Now the fun parts comes here. Now what we need to do here is that, let me go to the diagram once again. Now what we are going to do is that we want to kind of increase the size of this overall background in such a way that only the transparent part should be visible. So what I'm saying is that I'm gonna just increase the total size of these two shapes, and just this part should be visible and this should be hidden. So to do that, what I'm gonna do is that go to this link class and say background size, and I wanna specify it a size of 200%, and we need to provide the X value also. So now you're gonna see that only the transparent part is visible and you cannot see the visible one, solid color. So if you go ahead and set its a background position and you set its value to 100 for the x-axis and 100 for the y-axis, you're gonna see that solid color once again. Now you're gonna see that behind this text, but we need just for the 50%, so I can specify 50%. Now one more thing that might be bothering you is that the height of this shape, this is little larger. So let's go ahead and fix it by specifying line height and setting it to 1. All right, that's looking great. Now we are going to use this background position to create our custom link hover effect. Just simply cut it and go to the link hover and here paste that value. And if you hover over on this link, you're gonna see how this is looking. This is really amazing. Now we need to specify kind of transition so that it smoothly animates or transition. So I can say transition inside the link and specify the property that I want to animate. In this case, that is background position, and we have to specify time. So I'm gonna give 200 milliseconds and the timing function, so is in out. And if you do this and hit save, now let's go ahead and see. Okay, this is cool and it is looking fine to me, but you could further tweak this out by using the custom cubic bezier timing function instead of this is in out. So let's go ahead and do that. Just go to cubicbezier.com, and here you need to select the custom timing function. What I want is that I want to create a follow through animation effect where the shape would move to the up a little farther from its original location and comes back to the bottom. And we can do so by extending the curve from the graph boundaries. Just like that. And let's decrease the timing and hit go. You're gonna see the pink box, how it is moving. Now just simply copy the cubic bezier curves and go to this is in out and paste it right there. Hit save, and now you're gonna see how cool this effect is. But I can see one more problem where the linear gradient is kind of repeating above that link. So to fix that, you can just simply go ahead and inside the link class, you can specify the background repeat property and just set it to no repeat, and it's gonna fix the problem. Now see how cool the effect is. I really love this effect. And now you could also go ahead and change this property x-axis to 100%, and now you're gonna see how cool that effect is. So I really like this linear gradient and the background image property, which let us create a custom link hover effect without using any kind of markup to our HTML to create this kind of shapes. So interesting part is that it is supported in all the browsers. So I hope, my friends, you have enjoyed this video. And if you like this video, please go ahead and like the video, comment your thoughts in the comment section, and please go ahead and consider subscribing to the channel so that you can get more delightful content direct into your inbox. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my next video. Thank you.